Ladies and gentlemen, look at what we have here today. Achu soup, or sojourn as some people call it. Yes, this is what we are making today. One of my favorite soups, especially when it's got lots of pepper in it. Oh my god, and you know the way it's eaten with achu, one finger go around the world. Oh, so this is what we will be making today. Please don't forget to hit that subscribe button. If you're just meeting this channel, Afro Cooking Channel, for your first time, here we bring you recipes from all around Africa. And if you're on Facebook, just hit that follow button and give us that like to show your support for us, and so that YouTube can also get to recommend it to other people. So today I will be showing you how we make this beautiful looking soup. Let's go. So this is what I will be using for this recipe. Here I have my seasoning, here I have dried thyme, I have white pepper seasoning, all-purpose seasoning, curry powder seasoning, hot chili pepper, and of course seasoning cubes. I'll mainly be using this to boil the beef, so I will be using beef pomo, or what some people call kanda. In Cameroon we call it kanda, while Nigerians call it pomo, and dry fish, yes, and of course onion. Yeah, so I'll be using the onion and the seasoning to boil the kanda, beef, and dry fish. I'll be using the seasoning to boil it. The meat broth here is very important for this achu soup we want to cook, because the meat broth is what will give you the thickness, you know, give the thickness to the soup. So the meat broth is very important. So I'll go ahead now and boil the beef kanda dry fish, and of course definitely use salt, you know, to also season the meat. Yes, so the meat is ready. You can see the meat, the kanda, the dry fish is all ready, and this is the main seasoning or the spice that is used for making achu soup. This is the mix, achu spice mix, which means it's a combination of all the spices put together, you know, make easy. So all I will need to do is to put about 2 tablespoons of this in the achu, and you know, you just taste it while doing it, and know, and until it tastes good as it's supposed to, you just put the spice and just taste it as you go along. But it will take about 2 tablespoons, and this is limestone. We call it kangwa, and I think Nigerians call it ikang, so something like that. Yeah, so we call it kangwa. Basically in English it's limestone. It is, yeah, it will be used for making the soup. And this is the meat broth. You know, I said it is the basic, you know, the basis for the achu soup. You need it because it's gonna give the soup that thickness, that taste. So what I did was I took out the meat and I strained the soup. I put it on a sieve to sieve out all the little bits and pieces of fish, onion, you know, to strain it out. And you just have the water of the meat. This is it. I will be using it. So I will go on ahead now and put my palm oil. And guys, the water does not need to be very hot. The water just needs to be, let me see, warm, about there about, because this soup, you don't want the palm oil melting and, you know, and, you know, getting cooked and so on. Basically you don't want at the end of your soup and then the oil is
floating on top, so the water does not need to be very hot. So when you take it out the fire, you allow it to cool down a little, not like going cold, but still warm but not very hot. Yeah,
so this is the palm oil. I just put it on the fire to warm up a little. You don't have to bleach the palm oil. If you bleach the palm oil, it's gonna go wrong. So you just warm up the palm oil. So I'll go ahead now and put in the, so I have put in the kangwa, which is the limestone. I'll go ahead now and pour in the meat broth into the soup. Yeah, and you see I put a big piece of kangwa. This is the big piece of kangwa. I'll just go ahead and stir it while tasting. I'll go ahead and stir it while tasting the. Stir it in the soup so it's melting and getting in the soup while also tasting it. So I will go ahead now and put in the Achu soup mix. There you go. I'll put in about 2 tablespoons. So basically I'll have to taste it to know if it's okay. So I'll go in now and mix. Guys, after mixing it and tasting it to make sure the Maggi is okay, the pepper is okay, I'll go ahead now and blend it in a blender, and that's what is going to give the whole mix of the soup. So this is another spice they call Rondel or contry onion. I'll go ahead and put it into the soup as well and mix it. Remember, the meat stock already has the salt and the Maggi, so I won't actually be adding any salt or Maggi to it. So this is the mixture that I have transferred to the blender. I have taken out the kangwa from it, so you don't blend it with the kangwa. I've taken out the leftover kangwa from it. I'll go ahead now and blend it to give it a good mix, and that's where you see that yellow color appearing. So you can see that guys, can you see that? Wow, perfect. Can you see that yellow color now? So yeah guys, you can see that yellow color now, right? The Achu soup or the sauce jaune is ready. So guys, go ahead, taste it. If the kangwa is enough, that's if the limestone is enough, if the Achu soup spice mix is enough. If it's not enough, you can always go ahead and add it. If the pepper is enough, you can always go ahead and add it to whatever taste, you know, what taste for you. So I have tested mine, the kangwa and the pepper is not enough, so I'm gonna go ahead and add some more chili pepper and the kangwa to it. So guys, this is the Achu soup. It is ready. You know, I went ahead and added in the kangwa, a little bit of contry onion, the achu mix, some chili pepper, and you know, the pepper. So basically it's you putting the things and tasting them to make sure it gives you the taste that you really want, you know. So you can see it, it's yellow. And sometimes if you make this soup and you see the oil hanging out or floating on top, probably maybe the kangwa was not enough. So those are the things you check out for. Now, what do we eat this soup with? We eat this soup mostly in Cameroon with a type of fufu called achu. you know, it's made of cocoyam that is cooked, pounded. So basically, guys, I will be showing you. And if you live in London, United Kingdom, there is a shop at New Cross called Afro Cash and Curry. There you have the Achu spice already mixed together, like the one I was using. I got it from there. Just, you know, cooking made easy, just ready for you to use. So I'll be putting the address in the description box below. Thank you. Yeah, so this is the kind of cocoyam you use to make the Achu fufu. So it has been boiling. Actually, you can buy this from fresh and cook it yourself, or you can buy it already cooked and frozen, which is what I did. You know, it's been sold in the Afro Cash and Curry food shop at London New Cross. So I bought the frozen cooked cocoyam. I just put it on the fire again to get it cooked to the cooking mood again, because it's already been cooked. So to get it really hot, because when it gets hot, it's soft for you. So I traditionally they do pound the cocoyam in the mortar using a pestle, but you know, machines have come up to make things easy. So this is a mincer. So I just peel the cocoyam and I put it in a mincer and I push it down with this, and then you see how it comes out. Then I now mix it in my bowl. So look at how the fufu is come out, very nice, smooth. And I'll be eating this with the soup. So you see, I'll go ahead now and round it, make it round on the bowl and make a hole in the middle. Yeah, so guys, look at it. Maui wok, must chop. Yeah, by now you should already know this is my best time. Tasting time, yeah. So you can see how good it's looking. So this is Achu, and Achu soup, of course. So how do we eat this Achu? You just go in with your finger, take with your finger. Of course, I've already washed my hands, so yeah, it's best eating with a finger, guys. Look at it. Oh my god, I don't need to tell you how it tastes. Of course, it's so lovely. And of course, the pomo. Guys, tastes so good with the kanda. So this is it. Thank you so much for watching. Please hit on that subscribe button, the follow button, to get more recipes coming your way. Thank you very much for watching. God bless you.